Hey everybody, Shug here. And here's a sight many of you haven't seen. Me using a tent. Pop! So what I wanted to do was take a look at, if I go to sleep on the ground, I want to use my top quilt, but I just wanted to look at some of the differences between a sleeping bag and a top quilt on the ground, not necessarily in the hammock. Right there we have my 20 degree Alpine Light Western Mountaineering sleeping bag. It's a beaut. Right here, my HammockGear 20 degree Burrow top quilt. And here, just for the fun of it, because I haven't looked at it in a long time, is my REI 0 degree Kilo sleeping bag. This is the bottom side of the top quilt from HammockGear. Your feet go in right here. There's a little piece right there. This is your foot box, really, from here to there. And you can see how the rest of it spreads out. It's about 70 inches long because I'm 6 feet tall. And like I said, it's 44, 45 inches across from here to here. But it's tough to tell when it's all puffed up with this down right here. What I want to look at are the pros and cons on a sleeping bag and a top quilt on the ground. We're going to take a look at the loft on here, meaning how puffy it is when it's, you know, laying on the ground with the down. And that thing on this baffle, this outside baffle, man, that's about 4, 4.5 inches of loft on there. So I ain't scared to use this on the ground. I got an eyebrow here that's just going wild there. I got to get that thing. So with the top quilt, like this HammockGear, you have a snap at the top. And man, that really makes it much nicer for using on the ground. Slip it over your head. And what I'm doing is I'm just reaching up under myself and grabbing it and tucking it up under me a little bit. I'll lay here. And then I'll just take the pull right here, the cinch. Cinch that up. And here's the nice thing about these. I keep wanting to put my arm out the top like a sleeping bag. But with the top quilt, you just come out the bottom. Because honestly, in a sleeping bag, you get a little bit of warmth from the down compressed up underneath you, but you lose most of it because down is all about the loft, meaning what I just showed you on there, the height of the down that catches, you know, the warm air coming from your body and traps it. That's the science I understand. Of course, you know, I am no academic. But I have this hood, and you can buy these add-on hoods. You can get them from Black Rock Gear, and Jacks Are Better. I got this one off an old jacket. So if I was using a top quilt, I'm just going to use an add-on hood like this. And then just taking my hand on this side, I'm just kind of reaching down, tucking it in around me. Same thing. If I'm a side sleeper, you gotta do just like a sleeping bag, get it on you straight, reach around where your buttocks and back are, just tuck it in. And I can feel the warmth of this down mat, pretty nice. Wanna get out quickly? I'm out. Everybody's pretty familiar with a sleeping bag, and when I got this sleeping bag, I spent close to $400 on it, mainly because Western Mountaineering really designs their bags with a, over here on the zipper side, there's a flap, and less than any other bag, my zipper hardly ever got stuck opening and closing it. If you've got a, well, if you've got a sleeping bag, I'm sure there's been times when you're all in there and you've got to get out and you just can't get that zipper down because it gets stuck. So here I'm all zipped in this. You got your articulated hood. I can pull that hood up tight. And also I can cinch this end, which has a draft collar in it. This Western Mountaineering bag has the nice baffle. It goes across your chest. So when you're sleeping in there, you know, you've got these two baffles right there. And you know, if you sleep in a sleeping bag, you know, you just have to get the know your sleeping bag by feel. And when I zip out of this, It works great. It very rarely got hung up on me. I've had a lot of sleeping bags that, man, I was trying to get out to pee, trying to get that zipper down and it was hung.
Yeah.
But this bag I love. I use it over my hammock as a pod in sub-zero temperatures here in Minnesota. But the one I'm excited about the most here right now is this HammockGear top quilt. Sure, could you show me the weights in pounds, ounces, and grams, please? If we have a bit of a looky-see, the Western Mountaineer and Alpine Light is 33 ounces, which is 935 grams, which is 2 pounds, 1 ounce. The REI Kilo, 0 degree, sleeping bag, 2 pounds, 5.9 ounces, 37.90 ounces, 1,076 grams. The HammockGear Burrow 20 degree, which even has a little overstuff, 1 pound, 6.2 ounces, 22.20 ounces, 630 grams. All right, here we're taking a look at the two sleeping bags and the one top quilt in their stuff sacks. That is the REI 0 degree Kilo sleeping bag. This one is the Western Mountaineering Alpine Light 20 degree sleeping bag. And this one is the HammockGear 20 degree top quilt. And I just added my water bottle in there, my Camelback water bottle, just to give you an idea of the size of these. And that becomes important in the real estate inside your pack. And the size and the volumes of things, that comes into play when you're loading a pack. So that's just another consideration on all of this stuff. Now this Exped Downmat, super nice. It's very comfortable. But it's kind of heavy. It's over 2 pounds. And then I got the REI Stratus right here, which is just right in between. Not too heavy, not too light. Oh yeah, you know, if I got to go to the ground, I think this is the mat I would carry. I think it'd be a little warm underneath you in, you know, in summertime, which would be a good time to go to one like the REI Stratus. But I like this a little underinflated, and I can feel the warmth already coming up through my back. Now, lay on the Stratus. I mean, for a ground pad, this is pretty comfortable too. I mean, it's like an air mattress. I was just down in the Limble Gorge and there was a guy named Cranky Bear down there and he's had some back surgery and he can't use a hammock anymore. So he's gone to ground and he showed me this little pump. It's really light, runs on two AAAs. I'm gonna show you how it works right now. All right, let's see how many breaths it takes me to do this. I think it's 16. Breaths and a light head rush. All right, we got the Stratus totally deflated again. Let's pump it up with the little pump. You just kind of open it like this. It's the little lid. Opening it all the way starts the pump. So you want to leave it about there. You pull this out. And this little rubber part here will go around the nipple. Now I'm going to slide it on there pretty good. All right. See how long that takes. Got a couple of chores done while I was at it. Swept the tent out. Forgot what that's all about here with fall and the leaves going in and the crud off my shoes because I didn't take my shoes off. But let's watch this thing inflate some more. All right, that's pretty good. I think the rest we can do by mouth. That's about 2 minutes and 30 seconds or so to get it that much inflated. So we'll just take it off. Put a breath in and lock it off. Ooh, warplanes. I love when that happens. I know since I've been doing videos, I haven't even slept on the ground. And nothing against tents, I just love my hammock too much and I sleep 10 or 11 hours sometimes. I feel rested in the morning. But I have been curious about really how a top quilt does for a full overnight on the ground. And only way to find out is to come out here and do an overnight and report back to you. I'm laying on the ground out here in this Go-Lite Shangri-La. Gonna see how this HammockGear top quilt gets me through the night. Gonna be the first time I've slept on the ground since pretty much maybe 2006. Good night, everybody. Good night. Well, a good morning to you, everybody. Slept on the ground. I slept very warm and comfortable inside this HammockGear burrow. I slept on my side for a lot of the night, and boy, you know, just tuck it up behind your buttocks and you are good to go. Toasty warm. So now I have proven to myself that a top quilt works great on the ground. Really miss my hammock, especially having my coffee here. I have to side sip it out of the side of my mouth. But all in all, if I have to go to ground, I know a top quilt will work now, but I do have two nice sleeping bags. I just wanted to clarify that, because I've been asked a few times and it's tough to give an answer on something when you don't know the answer yourself. So there we go. Good night. Now I'm going to go inside and hug my wife. All secured in Sector 7. Woo, buddy!